Yes, it is a good morning. I'll get it out, Robert.
Yeah.
It's 18 minutes after 7 o'clock. Thank you for tuning in this Wednesday morning. You made it to the middle of the week. Nice looking Wednesday morning. Nice sunny morning. And be grateful you live here. We've got it nice. It's not necessarily the way it is everywhere. I'll explain them in a little bit. I don't think you need me to explain them. I'm sure you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Horrible weather outside of our state. We have some horrible in the state, too. It's just in the panhandle. All right.
Yep.
Let me tell you what we're doing this morning. 7:35, we'll talk about that a little bit. The flooding up in Pensacola and in the panhandle. And there's a couple of states of emergency that have been declared up there. And I think they're still trying to figure out what to do. So I'll kind of give you whatever I know about the latest on that.
It's scary.
8:20 today. Sarah Evans is a social media correspondent, and she's coming to tell us how the latest enhancements of consumer technology are revolutionizing the cable industry. Calling in live. Oh, she's calling in live from the National Cable and Telecommunications Annual Convention in Los Angeles. Wow, she's getting up early. 5:20 LA time. Wow. She's also one of Forbes 14 power women.
Yeah, that's pretty awesome.
14 women to follow on Twitter. I got more than 14 I follow.
Yeah. Is she one of them?
I'm teasing. I have no idea who I follow around. I don't know who I follow. Hey, if I hear a funny line in my head, I say it. Doesn't matter what it matters.
That's right.
What repercussions I'm going to get from it. News Bites today at 8:35. I will read news with you, Robin.
We will read news, and
we'll shorten it so that our listeners will be able to get on with their day. And got a lot of stories. Boy, this morning I came in and I had news to do. So it takes me, I put the news together at home, and then I get all that done. I take a shower and get in here. So maybe there's an hour that passes between the time I finish my news and the time I get in here. It was like two or three news stories.
So
I had to rewrite my news, basically, because there were some news stories. And it was just the way, that's just the way it is. And I'm not complaining. I'm just explaining. Just telling you, really. I'm not even explaining.
We have no service. You get it all.
Howard Falco. We had a story yesterday where we were eating.
Yeah.
Remember I had my phone?
Yeah,
you had. That story about that guy. Never mind.
Yeah.
The Sterling story.
The basketball owner. Yeah, all of a sudden we're eating, and then you get this buzz on your phone, and it's all the information is right there.
The guy and the lady sitting near us, we're talking about that.
Yeah.
And then I got this buzz on my phone from the news thing that I subscribe to, and I wanted to tell him, hey, I got an update for you. But we both sound terrible, don't we?
Yeah.
When we laugh, we both sound like Marge Simpson's sisters.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
All right, go ahead. You have one more thing?
I wonder if he would have embraced it, since we were sort of eavesdropping, couldn't help eavesdrop. He's only a few feet away. Maybe he would have appreciated it.
I don't know.
The update, or maybe
I don't
not.
Know. I don't yeah, know. You never know. Howard Falco is coming in at 9 to 5. He is going to talk about mastering the experience of life.
Yep.
All right. His book is called Time in a Bottle. All right, well, fine. He's a spiritual teacher. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. 9:35 in the studio, Pastor Luis DeJesus is coming in.
Yes.
I did ask him once, how do you pronounce your name? And he did say DeJesus.
Yes, yeah.
I've had calls telling me, Larry, it's DeJesus.
Yeah.
If the man tells me it's DeJesus, I'll pronounce it that way.
That's right.
I know. Most Hispanic peoples pronounce it Jesus. He told me. I'm just telling you what he told me.
Yeah.
So anyway, so he'll be in here. This is an awesome man, by the way. And he lost his son a year ago or so. His son was murdered. I think up in Pennsylvania somewhere.
Yeah, Philadelphia,
and,
I think.
And this is such a wonderful guy, really. I mean, he's such a touching guy, and he's the pastor of the New Hope Church, Assemblies of God, and he puts on this thing. I think this might be the third year he's doing it.
Yeah, it's the third
God year. In My City Prayer Walk. This is where people just get together and show, hey, you know, I believe in God. I'm going to wear a T-shirt that says so, and I'm going to gather with other people who believe the same thing, and we'll wear the same T-shirt, and we're just going to walk.
Yeah.
Just going to show everybody driving down the boulevard, hey, you know what? This is how we feel. Thank you very much.
Mm-hmm.
That's a nice idea, I think.
Exactly.
It's in my opinion. Anyway, so Pastor DeJesus will be here at 9:35 to talk about that, and I will clear up the name pronunciation.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, that's what he taught me, though.
Yeah, because he's been on the air with us before, and that's what he said.
David Young at 10:05. He's a Grammy-nominated singer, songwriter, musician. He plays two Renaissance flutes at the same time.
I know.
And that's cool, I guess. But his thing is, he's written a book called Channeling Harrison. He says that he channels George Harrison. George Harrison, the ex-Beatle, the former Beatle, who died, you know. And so George Harrison is channeling himself through David Young. I have a hard time with that one, Robin. I'll tell him so, too. I'll tell you know I have a hard time. I'm going to, for the sake of the conversation, look, you have 25 minutes to tell me your story.
Yeah.
So I don't want to, you know, I don't want to cause anybody not to be able to tell their story just by expressing my disbelief.
Yes.
I do this a lot. I suspend my disbelief for the sake of the conversation.
Exactly.
Let somebody say what they have to say, and then we can talk about it later.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a lot of people pick on me for that. I don't give them hardball questions. But look, they got 25, sometimes 10 minutes.
Yeah.
Tell me what you got to say. You know, we'll decide later on. I do the same thing with the vitamin people.
Right.
They'll come on, they'll tell us to take us on. What's that one thing? Oh, what is that one thing I've heard lately? Oh, the one, if you're losing too much weight, only take one pill.
Oh.
You know, that's like the 4-hour boner. You know,
exactly. That's right. 4 hours, you can have a good time.
If it's been for 4 hours, you go see, every guy says 4 hours, I'm buying that stuff.
Yeah.
Same thing with this one. Oh, really?
Yeah.
If you're losing too much weight, reduce it to one pill, I'm going to buy that pill. You know, they make this warning.
Yeah.
Warning, exactly. If you're losing weight too quickly, you better just do one pill a day.
That's right.
How many pills does that sell?
Exactly.
So, hello.
Yeah.
I'm just being honest with the way I feel about those commercials.
Sure.
But if he was a guest.
Yeah, then you'd, you know.
I would say I have to suspend my disbelief because you've got to have a chance to tell us your side because I could be wrong.
Yeah.
I can't believe I said boner on the air. So I'm sorry.
I know.
I can't take it back. I'm sorry.
Well, guys want to do that.
It just came out. All right. Did I tell you about David Young? Oh, yeah. He's the George Harrison guy. Yeah. Legally Yours at 10:35. I might need an attorney. John Fuller is an attorney at the law firm of Fuller and Fuller. And he'll be answering our legal questions at the time. 11:05. B. Tassiani and Dr. Frank Yeomans are coming on the air with us. The book is called Remnants of a Life on Paper, A Mother and Daughter's Struggle with Borderline Personality Disorder.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll find out what that's about. Aaron Duffy at 11:20. Aaron worked in sales on Wall Street and has a book called On the Rocks. It's a funny, bittersweet, yet heartwarming novel about friendship, family, and finding love.
A
nice book. You just to wrap up the morning. Well, the best thing that wraps up the morning is the last thing, which is Fun with Joe.
Oh, yeah.
Today I've got some more. Are you smarter than a, what do you call them again?
College student.
Are you smarter than a college student questions, right?
Okay.
Our segment with Galen. Robin, have you ever seen somebody walk past the window here in the paddock wall?
Uh-huh.
And they are holding a long skinny bag.
Yes.
Have you seen that?
Yeah.
What's in the long skinny bag? Do you know what's in the long
sandwich?
Skinny bag?
A foot long.
No, longer than that. No, it's a pair of pants. It's Lee's skinny jeans. Lee has packaged their jeans in these they call them skinny jeans, and they've packaged them in these long skinny boxes, which they then put into these long skinny bags.
Oh, that's cool.
Okay, now it's cool. I see, that's exactly the reaction I was hoping from somebody, and I got it from you. The reason I like the reaction is because it is the packaging that you're responding to, you're reacting to, not the clothing inside of it.
No, I love the packaging.
Okay, so today, let's talk about packaging. I have some interesting and cool-looking packages out there, innovative, eye-catching packaging.
Okay.
People will buy things because of the packaging.
Cool.
And there are some cool ones out there. Wait till I tell you about that. We'll do that when we have Galen on the phone and in about 20, what is it, 30 minutes or so?
Yeah.
He'll be on the air with us. Okay.
Yeah.
So real quickly, some other talking points today. Things people will be talking about.
Okay.
I suppose as you make your way through the day is the weather, which I kind of want to do a little bit at length at 7:35. So let me hold on to that one for a second. The Oklahoma execution is being talked about a lot. There was a death row inmate who was executed yesterday in Oklahoma, but there were some issues with the way he died. Apparently, he convulsed and writhed on the gurney, and the drugs didn't kill him right away. He looked like he was in pain. A second execution had to be put on hold. Anyway.
The person he killed probably was
the execution was halted, but the result was still death. So good. this is definitely something people are talking about today.
Yeah.
A private company says they have found what they believe to be the plane wreckage of the Malaysia Airlines Flight 370.
Oh, wow.
But others that are dismissing that claim. For one thing, the site where Geo Renaissance says it found the wreckage is in the Bay of Bengal, which is several thousand miles away from the current search area.
Gosh.
Who knows? We'll look. I'm just telling you because it's a story that's being talked about today. The children, the students who survived the South Korean ferry left school 2 weeks ago on a field trip with hundreds of classmates. They came back to come back today.
Oh, gosh. Or
already today. It's already today there.
They're going to hate that.
Without the scores of students who died at sea, about 70 survivors from the sunken South Korean ferry visited a memorial at the Danwon High School in Esnan, the high school that sent 325 students on a field trip.
That is so sad. So sad.
Very sad. And then the Sterling story, banned for life. The reviews are in. NBA Commissioner Adam Silver scored a slam dunk. Yesterday I heard Buddy Martin talking about this. There's probably nobody more appropriate to talk about it than the guys in the afternoon.
Yeah.
But it is a story that is being talked about everywhere. And I wouldn't disagree. I mean, I think it's a good idea. You're going to have all your sponsors dropping off. You might as well get rid of the guy. Right?
Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah. All right, we've got to move forward. We've got Fox News. And remind me to tell you about Jasmine Tea.
Okay.
I just thought of it at the last second. Remind me to tell you about Jasmine Tea. All right, we'll take a little break, Fox News, and then we'll be back with all of those things I promised.
Fox News Radio, I'm Steve Rappaport.
We have a tough locker room, and all of us are tough, but it almost brought tears to your eyes just to feel the support from, you know, our fans.
Chris Paul, after the LA Clippers beat the Golden State Warriors last night, Clippers owner Donald Sterling received a lifetime ban earlier for racist comments.
I am also fining Mr. Sterling $2.5 million.
NBA Commissioner Adam Silver.
I will urge the Board of Governors to exercise its authority to force a sale of the team.
Sterling did not comment on the decision. Oklahoma's governor ordering a review of lethal injection procedures after a botched execution. Clayton Lockett's vein failed as the drugs were administered. The
inmate suffered what appears to be a massive heart attack and passed away.
Department of Corrections Director Robert Patton. NASCAR fining drivers Marcos Ambrose and Casey Mears for a post-race fight at Richmond on Saturday. Fox News. We report, you decide.
There's more to Fox News Radio than meets the ear. Go behind the headlines and join the conversation on the hottest stories of the day on the Fox News Radio Facebook page. Be a part of the Fox News Radio Facebook fan community. Post comments and tell us your opinions. See behind-the-scenes photos and videos and post your reactions to the stories that matter to you. Click the like button on Facebook and connect with breaking news and features like Fox in the Fast Lane, House Call for Help, and more. Go to Facebook.com/Fox News Radio.
Weeknights, we're busting out a brand new lineup. First, market fraud, government abuse, corruption. At 5, nothing's off limits on money with Melissa Francis. Then, from bloated bank fees to consumer scams. At 6, Jerry's exposing the issues impacting your wallet. Plus, get smart market insight and trusted analysis you won't find anywhere else. At 7, Lou Dobbs is all business. And the first and last name in business, Cavuto. Shedding light on the biggest stories making headlines at 8. Only on the Fox Business Network.
Like it or not, springtime is just around the corner, and so is spring cleaning and those winter projects you've been putting off. But don't worry, Sunbelt Rentals is here to make your job a little easier. Our knowledgeable staff will help you find the right equipment for any job, big or small. Did you know that Sunbelt Rentals carries heaters, air conditioners, generators, lighting, traffic control, and so much more? So whether you're building it up or knocking it down, we've got the equipment you need. Get it done, rent it now. And right now, for a limited time, you can have it for less. Just by mentioning this ad, if you rent it Friday afternoon, you can keep it the whole weekend and only pay for one day. But this is a limited time offer, so stop into Sunbelt Rentals today, Northwest 27th, just a quarter mile east of I-75. For more information, just give us a call, 352-369-9101. 352-369-9101. Sunbelt Rentals. Get it done, rent it now.
Who would you feed if you had 50 chicken sandwiches from Chick-fil-A? WOCA and Chick-fil-A in the Paddock Mall have teamed up to reward one organization with 50 chicken sandwiches as a way of saying thanks for the great work that organization is doing in our community. And we need your help. See, there are so many great people doing great things that we need nominations. You can nominate your own organization or any organization you choose. Simply send an email to WOCA@WOCA.com. And in 350 words or less, tell us why the organization you are nominating should receive 50 free chicken sandwiches from WOCA and Chick-fil-A at the Paddock Mall. We'll review your nominations and then select one deserving organization each month. We'll announce the winner and even read the winning entry on the air. Make sure to include the contact name and phone number of the organization that you are nominating. And thanks from your friends at WOCA and Chick-fil-A in the Paddock Mall.
Now is the time to take advantage of Florida Credit Union's CD specials. Our 36-month CD comes in at 1.46% APY. A 24-month is working for you at 1.0% APY. All CD rate specials require a $10,000 minimum. With friendly service and rates like these, it's not hard to see why Florida Credit Union has your CD options covered. Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life. Call 352-237-8222 for more information. Must act by 4/30/14.
Stay informed on everything going on in the villages with the Village Spectator newspaper. The Village Spectator is exclusively devoted to the villages with news, commentary, and more. And yes, they have Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. Tom's Picks will refer the company that fits your needs, and all we ask is that you tell them where you heard about them. Call Tom's Picks at 804-1223 and pick up your copy of the Village Spectator today.
Now read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
All right. Thank you, Joe. It's 25 minutes before 8 o'clock. Nice looking day here. It's a beautiful day here at the Paddock Mall. And the temperature right now here at the mall, not bad. It's, hold on, it's 67 degrees.
Yeah.
We do have rain in the forecast, but there is rain out there just to the northwest of us and north of us. And I wanted to talk about this. There's some serious issues going on in our country. In our state, and let me talk about the panhandle a little bit. This is from, I don't know who this is from, MSNBC, I think. Torrential rainfall and historic flooding claimed at least one life so far in the panhandle. And this is part of this monster weather system that we've been hearing about the last few days that has so far killed at least 35 people in 6 states.
Gosh.
More than 24 inches of rain fell in Pensacola in a 26-hour period.
Wow.
That's huge. There was one hour when more than 5 inches fell in 1 hour.
Gosh.
Yes, last night between 9 and 10 their time, Central Time. 10 and 11 our time, obviously. Some bridges reportedly washed away. I-10. I-10. I always mix up 10 and 4 for some reason.
Yeah.
4 is the one in Orlando.
Yeah.
10 is the one in the North Park. Okay.
Yeah.
I-10 was closed for several miles from the state line, the Alabama state line.
Uh-huh.
It's just, and I saw photos, or a video rather, of a car driving through what looked like probably a few inches of water on that bridge. If you've ever driven on that bridge, you know you don't want to be on that bridge if it floods. Mm-mm. So I'm hoping that they got off. I don't know. It was crazy.
Yeah.
Let's see. The Weather Channel meteorologist Kevin Roth said they received more rain in that one 26-hour period than they received during the entire Hurricane Ivan.
Oh, my God.
A local state of emergency was declared in Escambia County. I have not received anything indicating that the governor has done something, but chances are he will. Mm-hmm. Everybody's being encouraged to just stay out of the area and stay off the roadways. And so if you've got family up there and you can get to them, just, I guess, touch base, make sure they're okay. Emergency officials had described it was the worst flooding they had seen in 30 years.
Man.
Roth, the meteorologist, Roth, Bill, what was his first name again?
I can't remember.
Kevin Roth said he's not sure if it was a record-setting rainfall yet because lightning knocked out their reporting station up there. So he wasn't sure if it was record-breaking yet, but he thinks it is record-breaking. The weather in the panhandle and in that area, let's see, the Weather Channel tracking a dangerous threat of severe storms. It's currently, if you look at the weather map, it's to the west and northwest of us. It's out in the Gulf of Mexico, and it's kind of bends up there right through. Mm-hmm. I'm not looking at it, but it bends up there and through the...
But it's coming our way.
It may be coming our way.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah, we are not sure about that because there's wind bringing it from the west to the east, but there's also wind pushing up from the south through the Gulf of Mexico, which is our saving grace, actually.
Yeah.
So we'll just keep praying that for our area, that continues. Pray that it goes away for everybody else.
And no tornadoes spawned from that, from each of the fronts meeting.
Well, speaking of tornadoes, listen to this. They had received, the Weather Channel is who I'm talking about. Oh, I'm sorry. No, the National Weather Service is who I'm reading from. The Storm Prediction Center had received 733 reports of severe weather since 7 a.m. Sunday, including 135 reports of tornadoes.
Gosh.
Dr. Greg Forbes is a severe weather expert. He said it's too early to know how many separate tornadoes actually touched down. Damage surveys will be conducted throughout the day. Several people have already been killed by tornado. Well, we already knew that part.
Yeah.
Anyway, so it's just flooded up there. Some of the tweets from the different weather, the alerts, they're using Twitter as their way of delivering these alerts. So it's okay to call them tweets, I guess.
I think so.
Here's one from Tallahassee at 5:40 a.m., and that would have been Central Time, which is 6:40 our time, just an hour ago. The heaviest rain is now impacting coastal Santa Rosa and Okaloosa, shifting to Baldwin, Alabama, and Escambia, Florida. So those areas. And that was at 5:40 this morning. Their time, 6:40 our time, about an hour ago.
Oh, man.
So while we're sitting pretty, looking at a beautiful, sunny, blue sky, right? Just a little overcast.
Right now.
But there is flooding up there. There was one photograph taken from the stairwell of a home looking down the stairs at the door. It looks like the door is covered, is submerged about a third of the way.
Uh-huh.
Looks like the water goes up to about the third way mark. Anyway, I'm just telling you, I know that this... By telling you, it doesn't really change anything except to kind of alert you. And as far as whether it's coming our way, which is an important question, I don't want to tell you the wrong thing.
Uh-huh.
I don't want to tell you the wrong thing, but I will do my best here to see if I can get one of these animated maps to help me out here. Because when I hit the animated map before to try to do this for you, it stalled. It didn't show me anything. So let me try it again now, see if I can get it going. I'm not to scare you, but it looks like it is coming our way. It sure does look like it's coming our way. The bulk of it is still north of us, and those winds from the south are still pushing it north. So it might be, oh man, we might just skirt this thing.
Gee.
This thing that has no name, really.
It's still scary.
Anyway, just be on the alert that this could happen. And it's right now, it's over Tallahassee. The alerts are coming out of Tallahassee. It's obviously flooded Pensacola, flooded, it looks like it's starting to flood Escambia. Uh-huh. And as far as Marion County is concerned, so far we're not doing too bad.
Yeah.
But it is having an effect over in, oh my goodness, so I was looking at a report in Levy County. Does the Suwannee River go through Levy County? It was the Suwannee River.
Sure.
Remember the Suwannee River was flooding in the northern part of the river. Well, now the mouth of the river where it exits into the Gulf of Mexico, the whole thing is starting to flood now. Uh-huh. And they had to close some roads over there in Levy, I think it's Levy County. Which is our neighbor.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And I don't know if it's affecting any of the rivers that we call ours, like the Silver River, the Ocala River, the Rainbow, the Withlacoochee.
Right.
I haven't heard any reports from there, but I believe this is all part of it. And I'm guessing we'll see some more of this.
And emergency management keeps on top of things. So if they feel, you know, that we're going to be flooded and sandbags are necessary, they'll send the alert to us at WOCA and we'll let you know where to get the sandbags for the distribution and stuff.
We will. We certainly will. That's a good point. But I would also like to point out for everybody, you know, once upon a time, it used to be that we in the media had kind of a monopoly on the accessibility to alerts.
Yeah.
Not true anymore. Two things I will recommend. One, get a weather radio.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't, I'm not endorsing anything that's self-serving here. You go to Radio Shack or your favorite radio store.
Yeah, Publix has them too.
Oh, Publix has them?
Weather radio.
I think I've seen them in Walmart.
Yeah.
Get a weather radio. If you can get one that is crankable so you don't need batteries, that's even better.
Yeah.
You know, you can just charge it by cranking it up. But if you get a weather radio, you can tune it into the local weather service and they will regularly tell you what's going on. The other thing is if you go to the Marion County Sheriff's Office webpage, go to the page called Red Alert and sign up. Just tell them, you know, say, hey, I'd like to get some warnings on my phone. Give them your phone number. They will text you when there's an alert. Mm-hmm. You know, we're now, tomorrow's the first day of May.
Yeah.
You know, the hurricane season was predicted to be light. But what happened last couple of years? They were predicted heavy and we had nothing.
Yeah.
So maybe this year they predict it to be light. It'll be, who knows? All I'm saying is that we have now the ability for all of us to have these alerts in our pocket, literally.
Yeah.
You're out, you know, shopping or whatever. Your pocket vibrates or rings or whatever you have it set to. You look at it, oh, what is that? Oh, look at this. Look at this. The sheriff's office just alerted me that there's a tornado coming. We got to take cover. Yeah. That is exactly what saved somebody's life in one of those stories that I heard yesterday out, I guess that was in Alabama.
Yeah.
And so just, you know, I'm not trying to make a bigger thing of it than it really is, but it needs to be made into a big thing. I mean, this could be serious stuff, and it's probably short-lived, but short-lived could mean, you know, long-term damage that needs to be repaired or... and if you know about it in advance, you could prevent, you know...
Death, maybe.
Death. You might not be able to prevent damage, but you could prevent death. Yeah,
yeah.
I didn't want to say the word, but you were right on target.
Yeah.
All right, so... There you go. That's part of our job is to make sure we kind of scream a little bit about some of these things so that if you were taking nothing to worry about. And there might be nothing to worry about. I don't know. But it looks pretty bad. And it does not look absolutely certain that it will hit us.
Yeah.
It does not look absolutely certain. But it looks like it looks like it will skirt us. Mm-hmm. The farther north you go, the more likely it is that it will affect you.
Yeah.
So there you go. All right, we've got to push forward, and we've got our local and state news, and we'll be back. And then at the top of the hour, we'll speak to Galen Unold from LifeSouth. Again, he's directly responsible for making sure that there is blood available for anybody who needs it, which is one of these times right now when you have weather causing need for blood. So if you can go get over there. Donate blood, but we'll emphasize that more when Galen's on. Plus, I have a fun topic with Galen, as I always do. All right, we'll take a break and be right back. This is The Source, WOCA Ocala.
This is the Salvation Army, and I'm Major George Patterson to let you know that the Salvation Army is available 24 hours a day to provide help to anyone. We also have a family store at 120 Northwest 10th Street in Ocala. On Tuesday to Saturday from 9 to 4, you can do your shopping, or if you want to donate, you can call 352-732-4469 and we'll even pick up. 352-732-4469. All funds generated by our store go into the programs here in Marion County to help the needy.
Here are today's headlines from the source, WOCA. Torrential rainfall and historic flooding claimed a life in Florida's panhandle late yesterday, the latest fallout from a monster weather system that has killed at least 35 people in six states. More than 24 inches of rain fell in a 26-hour period in Pensacola, washing away bridges and closing mile after mile of highways across the region. More than 5 inches fell on Pensacola in a single hour between 9 p.m. and 10 p.m. Central Time, according to the National Weather Service. Weather Channel meteorologist Kevin Roth said that's more rain than Pensacola got during Hurricane Ivan. I-10 was closed for several miles from the Alabama border after a raging torrent of water made it impassable. The Levy County Department of Public Safety is reporting that at 2:45 this morning, the Levy County Sheriff's Office received a 911 call for a possible structure fire in Morriston. Firefighters responded and found a mobile home fully engulfed in flames. Marion County Fire Rescue, as well as Williston Fire Department and Bronson Fire Department, assisted with the call. The structure was declared a total loss. Two patients were transported to the hospital for further evaluation and treatment. And the Marion County Sheriff's Office is searching for the suspect that committed armed robbery of the Murphy Express store at 17 Cedar Radial Pass at around 3:40 a.m. on Monday. Security photos show the suspect wearing a white T-shirt over his head, a dark long-sleeve shirt, blue jeans, and red sneakers. The witness described the suspect as a black male standing about 5 feet 9 inches tall, weighing around 165 pounds, and between 19 and 25 years old. If anyone has any information about the crime, they are encouraged to call Crime Stoppers at 368-STOP or go online to OcalaCrimeStoppers.com. When U.S. Representative Alan Grayson married his wife, she was already married to another man, according to a new court filing by the congressman's lawyers, seeking an annulment on the basis of bigamy. Grayson's new filing, a counterpetition to Lolita Grayson's January divorce filing, states that when he met Lolita Grayson in 1985, she represented herself as single in order to induce Mr. Grayson to marry her. In her application for their marriage license, Lolita Grayson claimed she had been divorced since 1981, her husband says. The filing says Miss Grayson was married to another man up to and after the Graysons were married on April 28, 1990. The report states that Lolita Grayson secretly participated in a divorce from her prior husband, identified as Robert Carson, on March 7, 1994. Alan Grayson represents Florida's 9th Congressional District, and he is seeking re-election this year. Four public high schools in Marion County are nationally ranked this year by the Washington Post and U.S. News & World Report. The Washington Post's most challenging high schools list ranks Bellevue High School at number 323 and Vanguard High School at number 878. This year's prestigious list ranks 2,110 high schools nationwide. And two other high schools earned bronze status on this year's U.S. News & World Report rankings, Lakewood High and Westport High Schools. WOCA The Source stands to congratulate the teachers, students, parents, and support staff of our local schools. And if you've ever attended a show at Ocala Civic Theater and wondered how do they do that, you'll have a chance at the annual open house and backstage tour happening Saturday, May 17th from 10 a.m. till noon. This is also your chance to get an up-close and personal look at the set, props, and costumes created for Camelot, which runs May 15th through June 8th. And by the way, the tour is free. And those are the headlines from the source, WOCA 96.3 FM and 1370 AM.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Life jackets save lives. Where in Florida? Sunshine and some clouds, warm and humid today with a shower and thunderstorm around this afternoon and this evening. The high 86 to 90 and partly cloudy and warm later tonight, though 68 to 72. Tomorrow, intervals of clouds and sun with a shower and thunderstorm around in the afternoon. The high 84 to 88. And for Friday, clouds and some sun and not as warm with a couple of showers and a thunderstorm. The high 79 to 83. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Joe Lundberg.
Legally Yours, brought to you by Fuller & Fuller Attorneys at Law. On the air every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. with John Fuller, a board-certified civil trial lawyer for over 25 years. John welcomes your questions, from business to complex family matters to legal disputes. So tune in every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. for Legally Yours with John Fuller, right here on WOCA 1370 AM and 96.3 FM, The Source.
Friday at 10:30, the Equine Alliance of Marion County will host a special edition of Horse Sense featuring a Kentucky Derby preview. Farm Tours of Ocala is sponsoring this special. How would you like to visit working horse farms and see these magnificent horses up close and personal? Farm Tours of Ocala offers this thrilling opportunity to us. For more information about a tour, visit farmtoursofocala.com and listen Friday morning at 10:30 for the Horse Sense special.
All right, thank you, Joe. Yeah, that's coming up, right? 2 days from today, right?
Kentucky Derby this Saturday.
All right, we are back, obviously. And right now it is, what is the temperature here? It is 69 degrees here at the Paddock Mall. I just listened to Joe Lundberg's forecast from the Florida News Network. And if that's all you heard, you would say, oh, it's beautiful. Which it is. It's beautiful here. I mean, he's talking about our area specifically. And perhaps, I mean, he's talking about us specifically, so maybe we'll be perfectly fine. It's just amazing to look out, you know, through the technology that we have and through this window in the sky called the satellite and look down at our area and see this huge piece of weather coming our way, knowing what that huge piece of weather has already done through Texas and Mississippi and Alabama, right?
Yeah.
And other states, Tennessee, up even as far north as Illinois, right? And to think that, yeah, we're fine.
Yeah.
We've lucked out with a lot with the cold during the winter. We didn't really get that much. You know, we had a little bit, nothing big, right? It's unbelievable. But anyway, so I was just contrasting how the actual weatherman delivered the weather compared to the way I kind of emphasized it a little. I don't think I overdid it, though. I think that's it's probably worthwhile, especially. Hey, look, you got friends elsewhere and you travel. You could be heading that way. So
yeah.
So postpone it for a day. I would at least a day, right? And don't go west on I-10.
Yeah.
Right now, I mean I-10, if you were heading out west somewhere, you know, right now, that's not a good way to go. It's flooded. No. It's flooded at the state line over there by Mobile and Pensacola and all that whole area over there. All right. What did I want to do?
Jasmine tea.
All right, let me start with the jasmine tea. Have you ever heard of jasmine tea?
Yes.
You've heard of jasmine tea?
Jasmine tea.
Okay, now what do you know about it? Because maybe I don't. Okay, let me. Oh, that's kind of an unfair question.
I don't know anything about it. I just know what it says on the boxes at the grocery store.
Oh, really? You've seen it in the grocery store?
Probably. I mean, they have all those herbal teas in there, so maybe I haven't.
Then. Okay, so here's what I'm. Maybe
I probably haven't. It's got all the other herbs up there. It probably doesn't have jasmine.
Jasmine tea, when you buy it in the full leaf pearl form. Okay. Somebody's going to correct me if I'm wrong. The way you do this is you take a tall glass and pour hot water into it.
Okay.
So it has to be one of those glasses that can survive hot water.
Yeah.
You don't want it to be
not shattered.
Yeah. So a tall glass that can survive hot water. I don't know what they're called. A tall tea glass. And you drop these pearls into it. They look like little, about the size of a hush puppy. Like a hush puppy like you get at Long John Silver's. No, they're not tea bags.
Oh, okay.
They're like balls of leaves or something. I don't know exactly what it is. But as the jasmine pearls, which are, like I say, about the size of a small hush puppy, start to become affected by the hot water, it'll start to open up, and the water will start to become tea. It'll make tea.
Oh, now okay? I got to find this. That sounds cool.
But here's the coolest part. When it opens up totally, a flower literally like climbs for 2 or 3 inches. And then it's just a flower in your glass. So you have a pretty glass of tea. I don't have any idea what it tastes like.
Wow. No, I've not seen this then.
When I was looking at something because
that
something about China.
Now I gotta find
Shanghai. It. There was something on Shanghai.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I don't know. You said you saw it in where did you see it?
Well, I thought you know they've got all the different herbs on the different boxes of the herbal teas right. in public. So I thought maybe jasmine was one of them, but I'm wrong.
Okay.
So I'm not afraid to admit where I'm wrong.
Well, you could be right, Robin. I don't know anything about it. I just looked at it last night and I thought, wow, I never heard of jasmine tea. But maybe it's jasmine pearls, full leaf tea. I just looked it up.
Uh-huh.
So if you just get jasmine tea, you're probably right. It's just a tea bag. But jasmine pearls, full leaf tea.
I got to find that because it sounds really artsy.
Somebody out there, they must serve it at some of these Chinese restaurants.
Yeah, they must.
I am so unwilling to explore when I go to these restaurants.
Uh-huh.
I mean, even frog legs, I say no thanks.
No, those little octopus sitting there, no thanks. They stay there.
The things that look like, what the heck is that, right?
Yeah. Well, this is cool. Jasmine pearl tea. So I'm writing that down to find it.
All right. Well, we have another moment before we head over to our news, and then we'll speak to Galen. You know, there's a kind of a very serious political story out there that's going to cause some shockwaves. And I would imagine people like Rush Limbaugh and Glenn Beck and Sean Hannity, I'm sure they'll be talking about it. Yesterday, an email apparently was sent around that says a White House official advises that former U.N. Ambassador Susan Rice is linked to the 2012 Benghazi attack to an anti-Muslim video, confirming the linkage was fabricated to help President Barack Obama's reelection. The email is a smoking gun. Is a quote from Senator Lindsey Graham.
Uh-huh.
They were on New Hampshire Senator Kelly Ayotte.
Uh-huh.
Was on Greta Van Susteren's Fox News Channel show, and simply said, "Where did the video reference come from? Now we know it came from the White House and not the intelligence community."
There you go.
Which has huge implications. Political implications. You can take that with, as Fox News says, you know, we deliver the news, you make up your decision about it, but
yeah.
But that's what the news says. The news says that they are indeed now saying that the original statement did come from the White House. And that it was not connected to that video that they said was uh-huh. was causing a reaction in the Muslim community over there. So
that's right.
All right, let me squeeze in a call or two, and we've got to move on to Fox News. So good morning, you're on the air. You there? Hello, hello. Let me try another one here. I did the right button, didn't I? Good morning, you there? Somebody there? Nobody there.
Yeah.
Try it again. Good morning, are you there?
Hello?
Hello, how you doing? Who's this?
This is Pauline Vereen in Ocala, Florida.
Hello, Pauline, how you doing?
I'm doing well. What about yourself?
Pretty good. What can I do for you?
Okay, unit has gone out, and I need you to come and check it for me, please.
What unit? What went out?
My air conditioned unit. This is coast to coast, isn't it?
No, but if you hold on, I can help you out. I've got you called a radio station, so let me.
Okay. Well, did I call 229-6221?
No, hold on, ma'am. Let me talk to you off the air. Hold on. Thank you.
Okay. 96.3 FM, the source.
Fox News Radio. I'm Lillian Wu. Clippers fans and the team reacting to a decision by the NBA to ban owner Donald Sterling for life. Head coach Doc Rivers weighing in.
I do think that's the right decision. The next step is where do we go?
Sterling could be forced to sell the Clippers. He's also fined $2.5 million over his recorded racist rant leaked to the media over the weekend. The Clippers topped Golden State 113-103 last night to take a 3-2 lead in their first round playoff series.
Fox Radio's Jeff Manasso. No reaction from Sterling yet. Hard hit parts of the South trying to pick up the pieces after deadly storms. This woman's house in Tupelo, Mississippi taking a direct hit.
I couldn't tell you the number of people that have just come up to my house and said, is there anything I can do? So it's definitely, we pull together.
People in the Florida Panhandle are also dealing with flooded homes this morning after the storm system made its way through that state last night.
Fox Radio's Tanya J. Powers. Fox News. We report, you decide.
There's more to Fox News Radio than meets the ear. Go behind the headlines and join the conversation on the hottest stories of the day on the Fox News Radio Facebook page. Be a part of the Fox News Radio Facebook fan community. Post comments and tell us your opinions. See behind-the-scenes photos and videos and post your reactions to the stories that matter to you. Click the like button on Facebook and connect with breaking news and features like Fox in the Fast Lane, House Call for Help, and more. Go to Facebook.com/Fox News Radio.
Weeknights, we're busting out a brand new lineup. First, market fraud, government abuse, corruption. At 5, nothing's off limits on money with Melissa Francis. Then, from bloated bank fees to consumer scams. At 6, Jerry's exposing the issues impacting your wallet. Plus, get smart market insight and trusted analysis you won't find anywhere else. At 7, Lou Dobbs is all business. And the first and last name in business, Cavuto. Shedding light on the biggest stories making headlines at 8. Only on the Fox Business Network.
Gene Powell Pasture Mowing. Our tractor services include bush hog, disking, front end loader, box blade, and stump grinding. We also have zero turn mowers for the smaller paddocks, aisleways, fence rows, and lawn care. Fence row spraying is also available for weed control. We are licensed and insured. Gene Powell Pasture Mowing, 352-629-2440 or online at PowellGene, G-E-N-E, at yahoo.com. Gene Powell Pasture Mowing.
It's cold in here. Ooh, it's hot in here.
Ah, it's just right in this house.
Looks like one out of three know about Climate Control Mechanical Services in Ocala. The first didn't call 291-0185. The second didn't know to call 291-0185. The third called 291-0185. So the moral of the story? To know is one thing, but to know and take action is another. Climate Control Mechanical Services. Just right.
Now is the time to take advantage of Florida Credit Union's CD specials. Our 36-month CD comes in at 1.46% APY. A 24-month is working for you at 1.0% APY. All CD rate specials require $10,000 minimum. With friendly service and rates like these, it's not hard to see why Florida Credit Union has your CD options covered. Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life. Call 352-237-8222 for more information. Must act by 4/30/14.
All right, thank you. 3 minutes after 8 o'clock, and Galen, you know, is on the phone over at Life South to remind us of the importance of donating blood. And the lady who called, for those who were interested, just had the wrong number, obviously.
Yeah.
But I wanted to help her out if there was something more I could do, right, other than just telling her to hang up and try the number again, because, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Galen, good morning. How you doing?
Hey, good morning, Larry. Robin, how are y'all?
Pretty good. Where are you today?
I'm on my way to South Carolina, so I'm on my way to Charleston.
No way. Where are you right now?
I'm about to go pick up my the guy I'm going up to South Carolina with, so I'm not in Gainesville yet. So getting close to Gainesville.
All right, you've got to, wait a minute, where are you going? You've got to look at this map.
South Carolina.
It's, I know, but it's going to hit South Carolina too. It's going to be everywhere.
Oh yeah, the storm?
Yeah.
Yeah, well,
it's your job.
Hold on.
Not a whole lot you can do about it.
Yes, there is. You can stop. You don't have to go. What good are you going to do?
I have to go.
Yeah. Where are you going in South Carolina?
Charleston.
Where's Charleston on the map, Robin? Is it? Charleston.
On the coast.
Where's on the coast? Okay. Well, get there quick.
Up in 95.
Get there quick.
Yeah, it's a 6-hour drive, so.
Yeah.
Well, hold on. Hold on. It's going to be raining there, though. Let me look.
It will be raining there.
It will be raining there by, hold on, I'm going to tell you. It says it right here.
I'll hit rain probably about once I get to Jacksonville today. So it'll rain probably the entire time.
The serious rain will be at 1.
Yeah.
1 o'clock in Charleston.
Yep.
So what is it now? 8,
it'll
9, 10, 11, 12.
There by then.
Right. Almost there.
Almost there.
Oh, you have an hour to go. 9, 10, 11, 12. 9, 10, 11, 12. 1. Oh.
8 and 12 is 4. 9, 10, 11, 12. And 1 is 5. Wow. 2 o'clock will be 6 hours.
I'm pretty sure I'm going to hit rain before that.
I know. You'll be like 2 hours in the rain.
At least.
You got to. What are you driving?
A car?
I know. So stop in Jessup. There's a nice hotel over there.
Yeah, I don't mind driving in the rain. I live in Florida. If you can't drive in the rain, you shouldn't live here.
This is not just rain, though. This is heavy stuff. This has got this has red in it. Usually you don't see red in it.
It'll be fine. We'll be fine.
Hmm. Why can't they do what needs to be done? Why can't the people who work there do it?
we don't have a blood center in Charleston at all. So we
you don't?
No, we're in South Carolina. So we're only in Florida, Georgia, and Alabama.
No, so you're trying to get one up there too?
No, not really. It's a conference and a convention. So.
Oh, okay. Well, that'll be good. Mm. It'll be interesting. Yeah.
Well, anyway, pretty much two-thirds of the area you cover are being affected by this storm.
We're getting slammed. We got slammed all day yesterday in Alabama and Georgia. So we actually really shortened our blood drives yesterday and just kept our people off the roads. So because the storm was pretty bad.
Keep our people off the roads.
Yeah.
Well, you know, there's one thing. Driving a bloodmobile.
Do as I say, not as I do.
Driving a bloodmobile is completely different than driving a car. It's a huge sail in the wind.
I know.
And, and people aren't going to be out and about, and businesses were closed up there. The storm's not going to be as bad as it was in Alabama. It won't be as bad in South Carolina as it was in Alabama yesterday.
Yeah.
It's going to dissipate a little bit. So we will take every precaution necessary.
Mm-hmm.
I have a lot to live for, Larry.
That's right. I know.
But you've got a job to do, too, so.
It's going to be fine.
Yeah, the world doesn't stop.
Well, okay. You're so confident of this. Let's change places. You're doing the show. I'm out in the car. You going to tell me to be careful?
Well, of course I am.
There you go. So then why wouldn't you be careful?
I'm going to be careful, Larry. I'll be careful. That was my mom. Yes, Mom, I'll be careful. I will not run with a knife.
Would you want me to go? If I turn the tides, turn it around on you, you're sitting here, I'm sitting there, would you say, why don't you just stay home a day?
I don't want to go. I just have to go. I don't have to go, but yeah, I have obligations and responsibilities, so I've got to do a talk tonight. I think it's 7:30, so
All right, you got to talk. All right. Well, that you just changed my mind here about something, because now that I know you're going to do a talk.
Yeah, I'm going for fun. I want to go and say, hey, let's go. to Charleston. Woo! Yeah, no.
All right. Well, hold on a second. You told me your son had a joke the other day that was published in the paper.
Yeah.
What was the joke again?
I think it was, what do dogs avoid?
What do dogs avoid? What is it?
Avoid flea markets.
Flea markets!
Oh, that's funny.
Are you going to use that on your speech?
I hope not.
So you should. You should use it.
You know what's great is is the program they have at school. They talk about it. It makes they're talking about newspapers and reading the newspaper and
right.
You know it's a media the physical newspaper is a media that's dying.
I know. It's a shame. I hate to see that happen.
That is a fact. People don't get mad at me for that, but. What they do is, they read the paper once a week, and that's the section that they read. And I find it fascinating because my son's like, so why don't you read the paper, Dad? I'm like, I do. I read it every day. Because we don't get the newspaper. I'm like, I read it on the computer online. He goes, oh. I'm like, he was judging me, like all of a sudden, I don't read the newspaper.
Yeah, right.
So it was pretty funny. And so they read that, and that's how they, my son, and he's been trying to be published in that Manatee for like 7 months. Since like the first day of school. And so he would come home and he'd go, Dad, I need a good joke. And so he would submit like 4 or 5 a week. And so when he finally got it, they do a phenomenal job. They gave him a T-shirt and this little certificate. And he was so proud of himself for finally making it.
That is cool. It is something to be proud of.
Yeah, well, it's, you know what, good for the newspaper for getting them, you know, these fourth graders to read the newspaper. So, and I thought that was pretty cool. That's better than, I don't know, I remember being in middle school, we had to do a current event where you had to clip out something from the newspaper and paste it to a piece of paper.
Right, right.
Right? So, I mean, at least they go in there and they read the paper and, you know, and they hold it. I think that's a really cool idea. So
it is a cool idea, yeah.
Because let's be honest, they're probably never going to, by the time they're our age, they will not be a printed newspaper.
Which is a shame. I mean, the beauty of a printed newspaper is that you will read other sections that you'd maybe not have been attracted to, but there it'll be, and you'll say, oh, what's that about?
Yeah.
There's absolutely some truth to that.
Internet newspapers, you basically go to the section you're interested in or the news you're interested in. You don't really stumble upon, well, you do, but not really.
Mm. That's one of the things that people are concerned about is what you become interested in is what you stay interested in because you're not exposed, as you said, to other things. And that's a real issue. And so the magazines that you like, you're not going to branch out from Time Magazine to, say, Outdoor Life, you know, so because magazines are probably going to go away at some point.
Yeah, yeah. And what about the comic section?
Download that you can scan it.
Is there a
I don't think there's a popular comic strip right now, currently.
No, I don't think so.
You know, I mean, there's a lot of, you'll see a lot, you know what's popular is people doing Vines and, you know, videos have probably replaced, you know, really funny video channels have probably replaced the comic strip.
Yeah, probably. Oh,
I think so.
Yeah, that's it.
I think so, yeah, because you see a lot of the children on there, too. They make their own YouTube videos and put it up there for their friends and, you know, they're pretty amazing when you see that stuff.
So are you in a place now where we can do our fun topic?
Of course I am. I'm always in a place.
Do you know what our fun topic is?
I do. It's packaging.
Packaging, yes.
And, you know, and I was thinking about this because packaging makes every decision that we do. It decides who we marry, right?
Good point,
Our own important, like whether it's a redhead or, you know, whatever it is, blondes, whatever. I mean, that packaging is what brings you in the first place.
That's a really good point. So, really good point.
So,
interesting.
And it's not just humans. It's every other animal on the planet. You know, it's every animal works on their package.
Exactly.
I wouldn't have put it that way, but that's good. Maybe I would have put it that way. All right. So here at the mall, you see interesting bags that pass the window. Okay, now bags are just another packaging. It's just the last package that you put them in.
And as a kid, you learn this at a very young age. There are some packages that you can't wait to have and that you wish you had more of.
Isn't that crazy?
You know?
Yeah.
You know, like growing up, if you had a Toys R Us bag, wow. Uh-huh. You know, that was oh my gosh, I got a Toys R Us bag.
Oh, I got a Toys R Us bag story for you. I know Robin knows this. I think I just told Joe this story. When I was a younger man, where I was young enough that my friends had children. I don't know if I had a child yet or not, but anyway. I was up in New York, and I was in the city with my friends, and my friend's wife wanted to go to FAO Schwartz. So we go, and I had always heard of FAO Schwartz.
That's
a great bag. Okay, that's what this is about. It's about the bag. I had never been to FAO Schwartz. I mean, I knew it was there. I knew it was famous and all that stuff, but I had never gone in there. So I went into FAO Schwartz with them, and of course, it's an amazing store, or it was. I don't know if it's still there. Anyway, so she buys this wooden train without motors or anything. It's just a wooden train. You push on a wooden track. And she puts it in a FAO Schwartz bag. And it was like $80 or something. And I said, you know, they sell it at Toys R Us for like $30. Toys R Us on Long Island. I don't know what Toys R Us in Manhattan would sell it for. Yeah, but it's not. Yeah, but then I won't have the FAO Schwartz bag. What's what I'm getting at here?
Yeah.
You're buying it for the bag? Bought it for the bag.
Yeah.
Absolutely bought it for the bag.
Yeah. Well, think about this. I mean, don't you want your wife to bring home a bag from Victoria's Secret?
A lot of those bags.
She can do that if she wants. I'll never see
her. Well, you know what I mean? I mean, that's kind of the point. Or, you know, or like if you want your husband to bring you something from, I don't know, K Jewelers or something.
Yeah.
Right? All right.
Yeah,
but,
you know, I think that's.
I don't disagree. No, I really, what you're saying is true. So let me tell you about the packaging. So Lee has a brand of jean they call skinny jeans. Mm-hmm. Okay. I would never be able to buy these, but they're real skinny jeans. And
I think if you're over the age of 22, you should probably wear skinny jeans.
But they sell them.
Who invented those, right, was Mick Jagger.
He may have. I don't know. I don't know if that's true. But anyway, they sell them in a long, skinny box, which is what explains the long, skinny bags that we see passing the window here.
Yeah, that is pretty cool.
We've got to find who sells the long, skinny, and we'll go in and look for it. Robin, there's a picture of it right there. If you see one. Have you seen that?
Oh, no, I haven't seen that. Isn't that something?
The long, skinny box with a handle on it, a little
thread. Yeah, it was 80 pounds, and I can get one of those.
There's a bun bread company, and they have marketed, they're marketing their buns as healthy buns, but they call them fit buns, and the packaging shows basically like the lower, the upper part of a man's jeans.
Uh-huh.
And his hands pulling up his t-shirt so that the buns are exposed and the buns look like his abs.
Oh, how cool.
Yeah.
That is cool.
That's fit buns.
Uh-huh. I like that.
Coca-Cola has a sharing can. Have you seen the sharing can by Coca-Cola?
Yeah. Yeah, it's a kind of a cool idea.
Have you seen this, Robin?
No, I haven't.
It's two cans in one.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, you buy a can of soda, you pull it apart, you give half to your friend and half is yours.
Really?
Yeah.
See,
now
right
that's
there?
Cool.
Right there. The Coca-Cola sharing can.
Oh, look at that. I got to find that. That's cool.
Can't buy two. There's an egg company called Happy Eggs. The egg carton is literally made out of straw.
Oh, how neat is that?
Or hay or something. But it looks like an egg carton, but I guess you could throw it away and it would be just totally biodegradable.
Yeah, that is cool.
There's a honey company, or it's BZZZ is the name of the company, Bzz, Armenian honey. They sell their jar of honey surrounded in this big wooden thing that looks like a honeycomb.
Oh, nice.
I'll show it to you soon.
That's cool.
You can maybe describe it better than me.
Boy, what cool gifts to give people because of the packaging.
It's all the packaging, yeah.
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 That is cool.
You know, honey bottles as a whole are pretty good packaging.
What is?
Honey bottles.
Honey bottles, yeah, right.
Right, because they're always like a bear, you know what I mean? And you know, it's a good packaging.
Yeah.
I don't know, that just popped in my brain. That was a random act.
No, but that's a good thought, though. I think you're right, yeah. Honey bottles.
And cereal. Cereal has great packaging.
It does.
Lots of colors and, yeah.
But could you imagine being given that assignment? Oh, we have an 820?
Yeah.
Oh, yay, yay. Okay, I'm sorry. All right, Robin. Well, we don't. I just wasn't paying attention. Gosh, I thought I could
have. I didn't know we had an 820 today.
I forgot to.
Yeah, we do today. Sorry.
All right. That's all right.
Okay, where's the Budmobile today?
Budmobile today, Larry, is back at the Walmart on Wedgwood Road.
The Walmart on Wedgwood Road, while you're driving all the way up to South Carolina.
Yep.
All right. All right. Well, be careful. If you can't get there, go to the where at the blood bank, the Life South.
Next on to Silver the
on the Boulevard. Yeah.
Yeah, on the Boulevard. And where would you go in Denali, Robin?
Right next door to the Winn-Dixie.
Winn-Dixie.
Use Dennis's idea. The
Winn-Dixie.
All right, Gail, you be careful.
You have to wait until your throats are better before you try that.
Yeah. All right. Be careful driving, Galen.
All right, I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. Bye, all.
All right, we will take a break, and we'll do our 820 interview in just a moment.
Yeehaw! Howdy, folks. R.L. here to invite you to DQ. Dairy Queen is serving the crispiest, juiciest, most tasty chicken tenders, all-beef chili dogs, and quarter-pound cheeseburgers on Earth. And you get crispy fries, a drink, and an ice cream sundae of your choice for only $5. Remember, at DQ, you can lick their gums, but you can't beat their shape. Dairy Queen, Silver Springs, where they always treat you like kings and queens.
This is a public notice. Local residents can now save thousands of dollars on their next car, truck, or SUV.
It's not a tent sale.
Because no tent is big enough to hold this many cars.
It's OcalaForSale.com.
Say goodbye to sticker shock. OcalaForSale.com has thousands of vehicles with no stickers at all.
But hurry. Don't walk, don't run.
Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting less proofing factory surcharge or delivery fee. See website for details.
Hi, I'm Yvette, and I'm here to tell you a few things about ABC Frederick's Appliance. They sell not only new, but used guaranteed appliances. When you call ABC Frederick's Appliance, they will provide service on what they sell and any appliances that you own. ABC Frederick's Appliance is located in Bellevue, right over the railroad tracks. Call 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. ABC Frederick's Appliance.
All right, thank you. 21 minutes after 8 o'clock. I apologize for everybody. I went a little bit long with the last segment. Sarah Evans is our next guest. She's a social media correspondent, a tech expert, named one of America's Tweethearts in Vanity Fair magazine. And she's going to tell us how the latest enhancements of consumer technology are revolutionizing the cable industry. And she's calling in live from Los Angeles. She got up early to do this. Good morning, Sarah.
I did. I got up early because I love you guys. Nice you.
Well, thank you for doing that. Thank you for being on the air with us. And how's the weather out there, by the way?
Oh, it's horrible. I mean, it's L.A. It's cold. It's rainy. I'm just kidding. It's like in the 90s.
Really, well, nice. I was buying into it. So what is everything is changing. We were just talking about how newspapers and magazines probably aren't going to be around much longer as far as the way we used to know them. What's happening with cable?
Well, cable's actually in a really cool time because it's all about personalization. If that's one trend that I've seen here, it really is that. Cable is innovating for the way that consumers watch and want to view content because they're viewing more content than ever. That's not an issue. It's the way they want to view it, whether it's on a second screen device like a tablet or a smartphone versus the primary screen. So it used to be all about who can get the biggest TV, and now it's, I want to take it with me.
Yeah, yeah. You know, one of the things, because of all the changing of the lineup of the late-night hosts, it came to our attention that there are a lot of late-night hosts now, whereas back in Johnny Carson's early days, it was really only him. But back then, there was only three networks. Now you got so many different networks.
So you can use that to correlate content needs. People want more and more, so that people are filling.
Is today the first day of the show out there?
Yesterday was. In fact, Monday we had some events, but yesterday was the first official day.
And what did you see that blew you away? Anything?
Pardon?
Did you see anything that blew you away that was really amazing?
You know, one of the cool things that I just didn't fully realize is how broad cable is, that it's so much more than TV now. I was looking at amazing broadband speeds. In fact, Cox just announced gig speed that they're going to be rolling out in some of their markets this year, to Wi-Fi, to home security. And personal viewing on wireless devices. So it's comprehensive. It's more than just what we thought of as TV, and the way that they're innovating through secondary apps on a tablet or a smartphone, it's just crazy. It's a whole Internet of Things home.
So do people really need to keep paying a cable company every month when they can get all of this on their phones?
Well, usually this content is provided through your cable provider. In our house, we're Cox Contour customers, and that means we can access about 133 different channels on our tablet. And it's huge during major sporting events because we have a 2.5-year-old, and if he wants to watch something like Mickey Mouse Club, we can set him up on that device. And we can't get the amount of content that we actually want in our household and the majority of Americans other than cable.
Wow. And so the Mickey Mouse Club still exists, huh?
It's a cartoon now. It's not the one. There's no Annette.
Oh, okay. So does the government has a couple times kind of dropped some news into our laps that said that they wanted to kind of create two internets, one that was a lower speed and one that was a higher speed. And I guess the higher one we pay for and the lower one we don't. What's the truth to that?
Well, I mean, it depends where. I mean, the government is going to... That's a whole separate entity. But if you look at what cable is doing right now, they're providing the fastest speeds, the most Wi-Fi hotspot. I mean, saying that, like with Cox rolling out this gig speed, that's amazing. And it it's not a separate internet. That's just what it will be once it's available in a market.
Do families view television shows together now, or do they just let everybody in their family watch what they want and they're in different rooms in the house?
So it's actually an interesting answer. That might be one case scenario, but a lot of people are actually using their secondary devices while they're watching TV on their primary screen. I know in our house, we're like most Americans in that there's at least 60 hours of viewing content across platforms, be it live streaming videos, recorded TV, on-demand movies, and you may watch together or you may split up to watch separate content. So our viewing behaviors are different than what they were even when I was a kid, where we gathered around the TV to watch a particular show live.
You know, and as far as information goes, you can watch one channel, and you've got the main thing happening. Like, let's say you're watching the news, right? Then you have this alert thing on the bottom, and then you have another scrolling message under that, and, uh-huh. and you literally are getting three or four messages at once, even from one channel, right?
Yeah, and we're kind of programmed for that now. And people will use complementary or supplementary content like we will. In our house, I said our iPads are secondary TVs for us. Well, if we want to watch something else on TV, we don't even need to scroll on the television. We can use our smart recommendation guide on the app to help us find new content and then push it live on our TV. So the way we even have to change the channel and find new content is completely different.
What role does cable have with our home security?
So cable's really getting into the home security and home automation market. And so I'm also a customer, and we've got the whole security system set up in our house. It's everything from creating smart thermostats that you can access from your smartphone to control, to the traditional security setting, to one of my favorite things is I also can control some of the lights in my home. So I can really mess with my husband and turn things off and on. But I can set up rules. I'm awful. But I set up rules so when I come in the garage door that a certain light turns on because I know I'm coming in the evening. So it's connecting my home in a brand new way. And, of course, there's the whole safety and security aspect from a brand that you know and trust.
Sarah, where is your home? Is your home out there or somewhere else?
I live in Las Vegas.
In Las Vegas. All right. Well, whatever you have there stays there is what I heard.
Pretty cool.
How come people don't have time to watch the programs on the TV that the programs are designated for, but they can record all of these programs and then find the time to watch the recorded ones? I could never understand that.
It's a great question. I don't think it's that people don't have the time. It's that they know they don't have to. You know, back when I was younger, you had to watch a show at that particular time or you just weren't going to see it unless it aired again at another time. But right. Now we're building our lifestyles around a culture where we don't have to do that. We can choose to watch something different. So I don't think it's a matter of not having time. It's that now we can create the time when we want it.
And not even to mention the challenges it provides to the advertising community. I mean, we now you have to figure people just skip over ads. You have to figure out some way to get the ad to them, right?
It's interesting because my two-year-old has already learned to say, skip ad. He knows that it's coming. But I think we're going to see innovations in the way advertisers are going to reach people through secondary screens. We're in a time of evolution and growth, and the cable industry itself is evolving and growing. So we're at a really unique...
Sarah, we're up against the clock. Is there a website we can tell our listeners about? Or any
other? Everything that's going on at the cable, so you can follow hashtag cable2014, or you can go to cox.com to find out everything I've talked about today.
All right. Sarah, thank you so much for being with us today.
Thank you.
Reacting to a decision by the NBA to ban owner Donald Sterling for life, head coach Doc Rivers weighing in.
I do think that's the right decision. The next step is where do we go?
Sterling could be forced to sell the Clippers. He's also fined $2.5 million over his recorded racist rant leaked to the media over the weekend. The Clippers topped Golden State 113-103 last night to take a 3-2 lead in their first round playoff series.
Fox Radio's Jeff Manasso, no reaction from Sterling yet. Hard hit parts of the South trying to pick the pieces after deadly storms. This woman's house in Tupelo, Mississippi, taking a direct hit.
I couldn't tell you the number of people that have just come up to my house and said, is there anything I can do? So It's definitely, we pull together.
People in the Florida Panhandle are also dealing with flooded homes this morning after the storm system made its way through that state last night.
Fox Radio's Tanya J. Powers, Fox News. We report, you decide.
There's more to Fox News Radio than meets the ear. Go behind the headlines and join the conversation on the hottest stories of the day on the Fox News Radio Facebook page. Be a part of the Fox News Radio Facebook fan community. Post comments and tell us your opinions. See behind-the-scenes photos and videos and post your reactions to the stories that matter to you. Click the like button on Facebook and connect with breaking news and features like Fox in the Fast Lane, House Call for Help, and more. Go to Facebook.com/Fox News Radio.
Weeknights, we're busting out a brand new lineup. First, market fraud, government abuse, corruption. At 5, nothing's off limits on money with Melissa Francis. Then, from bloated bank fees to consumer scams. At 6, Jerry's exposing the issues impacting your wallet. Plus, get smart market insight and trusted analysis you won't find anywhere else. At 7, Lou Dobbs is all business. And the first and last name in business, Cavuto. Shedding light on the biggest stories making headlines at 8. Only on the Fox Business.
Yeehaw! Howdy, folks. RL here to invite you to DQ. Dairy Queen is serving the crispiest, juiciest, most tasty chicken tenders, all beef chili dogs, and quarter-pound cheeseburgers on earth. And you get crispy fries, a drink, and an ice cream sundae of your choice for only $5. Remember, at DQ, you can lick their gums, but you can't beat their shakes. Dairy Queen, Silver Springs, where they always treat you like kings and queens.
Habitat for Humanity of Marion County is a ministry dedicated to improving lives by providing affordable and decent housing. Help them help others by visiting the Habitat for Humanity Ocala Restore at 926 Northwest 27th Avenue. To schedule a donation, give us a call at 401-0075 and we'll come pick it up. For more information, visit ocalarestore.org. Habitat for Humanity of Marion County. Building homes, building hope, building community.
Got a garden and we've got a show for you called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
Pick up your copy of Lady Lake Magazine, featuring local businesses and issues and written by local volunteers. Lady Lake Magazine has become a must-read in Marion, Lake, and Sumter counties, audited by Circulation Verification Council and serving the area for 23 years. Plus, Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. All we ask is that you tell them where you heard about them. Call Tom's Picks at 352-804-1223 and pick up your copy of Lady Lake Magazine today.
Now, read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Life jackets save lives. We're in Florida. Sunshine and some clouds, warm and humid today with a shower and thunderstorm around this afternoon and this evening. The high 86 to 90 and partly cloudy and warm later tonight, though 68 to 72. Tomorrow, intervals of clouds and sun with a shower and thunderstorm around in the afternoon. The high 84 to 88. And for Friday, clouds and some sun and not as warm with a couple of showers and a thunderstorm. The high 79 to 83. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Joe Lundberg.
Hi, this is Joe from Damage Control Services. Join me Tuesdays at 10:30 when we discuss what to do when your property gets damaged, how to fix it fast, and get back on track. At Damage Control, we specialize in helping home and business owners recover from damage caused by floods, fires, storms, tree damage, mold, and all other insurance-related disasters. So when disaster strikes, big or small, call Damage Control Services. Call me, 352-817-6574.
Hey, it's Christy with Ocala Mac and PC Repair and Ocala Guest Wi-Fi to let you know we have you covered. We are the only local certified Apple and Microsoft computer company in Ocala. We are family owned and operated. From mobile repair to wireless networks, viruses, new systems, or security cameras, we do it all. Check us out online, ocalamacpc.com, or give us a call, 352-566-8324.
Tell them Nick, Madison, or Mason sent you and get free diagnostic.
Get your internet telephone service from the company that brought affordable internet service to Ocala in the first place. Olive Save is a sister company of Ocala Guest Wi-Fi, a company you've known and trusted for all your internet needs. Whether you need a phone or hundreds, we've got the products and services to meet your needs both now and in the future. Our plans include everything from local and long-distance calling to equipment maintenance and even software upgrades. You can count on Olive Save to give you cost certainty knowing that your bill will be the same next week, next month, or even next year. Call 352-450-8647 today to learn how to cut your monthly telephone bill up to 60%.
Mark it down, Ocala, the only place in this town where you can buy double knockout red roses for just $10 is Bob Wine's Camellia Gardens. Better hurry, though, because they're going fast. Yes, gorgeous red double knockouts, regularly $19.99, still just $10 each this week at Bob Wine's. How about hummingbird plants? Dozens of varieties to choose from, starting at only $5.99. Why not plant a tree this week? You can still get large trees up to 6 feet for only $29.99, but you can always get bigger trees, all the way up to the super gigantic jumbos, only $4.99, delivered, planted, and guaranteed. Check the ad for a complete list of specials, but be there. Bob Wine's Camellia Gardens, Southeast 38th Street, Ocala. Open 9 to 5, Monday through Saturday, and growing greener with Ocala since 1952.
Ocala's information.